Hello students, I am back with my new video. Depressant. Student, lastly we have discussed about the CNS stimulants. So now we will discuss about the depressant, the another category of illicit drugs. So guys, whenever the depressant came in our mind, we used to think about the alcohol, the ethyl alcohol, which is the main ingredient of the beer and alcohol substances. So these usually known as the depressants. But students, I would like to tell you one thing is that in today's time, many prescription drugs are given in order to depress the central nervous system, and many patients used to abuse them as a depressants. So in the depressant category, we will today discuss about the barbiturates. So what are the barbiturates, students? Barbiturates are the depressant which are termed as the sedative and hypnotics. Sedatives, barbiturates in smaller dose known as the sedatives, which are used to produce the sedation or the sedative action. Whereas in the hypnotics, when barbiturates are given in the larger doses and are given as a sleeping pills, they are known as the hypnotics. So you must know the difference between the sedatives and hypnotics. Sedatives are given for the sedation. Hypnotics are usually taken for as a sleeping pills. So as the name indicate, barbiturates, the barbituric acid and the thiobarbituric acid are the two chemical substances, are the two compounds which are present in the barbiturates. The another point that I would like to tell you is barbiturates are the highly addictive, and withdrawal could be dangerous, and its withdrawal could be fatal. So the next point is, alcohol is the most interaction substance with the barbiturates. So one should take care of the detox of the interaction. So one should never take the alcohol with the barbiturates because they interact dangerously. The next point is, detoxification from the barbiturate can take months to years. Usually detoxification, or you can say withdrawal, is very much hard from the barbiturates. The addictives are not usually able to recover from the addiction of the barbiturates, and its detoxification usually takes months to years. Many people who used to take the barbiturates as well as the amphetamine, guys, in the previous lecture I have told you amphetamine was stimulant. When people take both these substances together, they become highly addictive of these substances. Usually you must be wondering that how a depressant and a stimulant can act together. Usually what addictives used to do is, they used to take the barbiturates along with the stimulants like the amphetamines, and in order to increase the effects, in order to increase the depression capacity of the barbiturates. So when it is taken with the amphetamine, it causes the highly addictive substance. It becomes the highly addictive substance. Moreover, one more thing I would like to tell you is that many celebrities have been died with the overdose of the barbiturates. So that's why it is very harmful addict drug. So you must understand this topic completely, guys. In the coming video, I would like to give you a mechanism of action. So the question here is, the compound present in the barbiturates are the barbituric acid and the thiobarbituric acid. I would like to ask you this question in the practice test. And which product is most highly interact with the barbiturates? Alcohol can interact dangerously. And which stimulant usually taken along with it is the amphetamine, in order to increase the effect of the barbiturates. Now come to the mechanism of action of GABA or the barbiturates. Usually students, barbiturate act on the GABA. GABA is the gamma aminobutyric acid. You all may aware of this thing, gamma aminobutyric acid. It is present on its receptor. So here I have shown a diagram in which I have shown multiple receptors, this and this, and the channel. This is the channel, this is the chloride channel. So this is the barbiturate receptor. This is the GABA receptor. This is the diazepam receptor. This is fluoxetine receptor. This is DMCM receptor. And these all are the benzodiazepine receptor. BZD is the benzodiazepine receptor. So how the mechanism take place, I am going to tell you in this. Actually, barbiturates primarily act on the GABA receptor as well as the benzodiazepine receptor, right? So when they act on these receptors, right? When they act on this receptor, this is the benzodiazepine receptor, it produces the inhibition of the GABA. Fine, they cause the GABAergic inhibition when barbiturate act on this receptor. I know there is another receptor for this, but it can act on the other receptor site also. But when it act on this gamma receptor, it used to inhibit the GABA, the gamma aminobutyric acid inhibition, right? And after some time, why it is inhibit? Because when barbiturate sit on this receptor, it cause the lifetime opening of the lifetime increased chloride channel opening, right? So whenever they sit on this receptor, barbiturate receptor sit on the DMCM receptor, it cause the chloride channel opening for the lifetime, which lead to the inhibition of the GABA. Fine. So this was the inhibition method of the barbiturate. Another way is barbiturate usually have alpha and beta receptors. Here is the receptor, alpha or beta receptor. They used to bind on this site only. Okay? When they are sit on this site, they produce the positive, like GABA stimulation. They produce the GABA facilitatory action. The main thing is of barbiturate is to stimulate the GABA opening, GABA increase, right? So barbiturate as well as the diazepam both used to sit increase the GABA facilitatory action, which in turn open the chloride channel. Fine, which in turn open the chloride channel. Now, as I have written here, in the higher concentration, barbiturate directly increases the chloride conductance and inhibit the calcium dependent release of neurotransmitter. So what is the main reason behind increasing all this is, when there is high concentration of barbiturates, they used to come here, the high concentration come here, they directly act on the chloride channel. As you can see, it is open from here, they use directly sit on this and increase the chloride concentration, right? So due to the increased chloride concentration, calcium dependent neurotransmitter release inhibit. So neurotransmitters such as ephedrine, norepinephrine, norepinephrine, which usually act to stimulate the our central nervous system, as we have seen in the previous lecture, the neurotransmitters such as norepinephrine, they used to inhibit, right? So when they inhibit, they will not able to produce the stimulant action, and the main action of barbiturate is to depress the central nervous system, right? So by this way, the action of the barbiturate simplifies and it clarifies clearly. If you are not able to see this, so now I think you can see it clearly. So if you understand the complete topic, you might be understand that why barbiturates are responsible for the CNS depression. In case you do not understand, please ask the question. So now let's move towards the second point of the barbiturates. I have told you that here in the very high concentration, they act directly on the chloride channel and directly increase the chloride conductance, which in turn lead to the calcium dependent release of transmitter inhibition. Fine, at very high concentration, this is the high concentration, and what happened at very high concentration in the addicts usually? In very high concentration, barbiturates start depressing the sodium and potassium channel as well. Right, so the system become very much depressed, person become lethargic, not able to do anything, not able to even stand. So at very high concentration, they used to depress the complete central nervous system. It should be called as the CNS shutdown. So at very high concentration, they inhibit the sodium and potassium channel as well. So now we will discuss about the effects of the barbiturates. In the effect of the barbiturates, small doses of the barbiturate can produce drowsiness, reduction in anxiety and excitability, which is its prime cause and prime responsibility. Another is it impair the learning and short-term memory and judgment, right? In very small doses, it act severely and shows the drowsiness and reduction in anxiety, and in higher doses it causes the addiction. Hyperalgesia in little doses, it is very much effective analgesic, and in very little doses it shows the hyperalgesia, like relief in pain, but it also have the potent anticonvulsant activity independent of the general CNS depression. No matter that CNS, how much CNS is depressed, central nervous system is depressed, it starts showing the potent anticonvulsant activity, and therefore it is also used nowadays. It shows the dose dependent effects, as I have shown you earlier, that in higher concentration it directly act on the chloride channel and inhibit the transmitter release, and at very high concentration it depress the sodium and potassium channel as well, along with the chloride and calcium channels. So it is a dose dependent manner, definitely. So it shows first of all sedation, then sleep, then anesthesia, and then coma. So moreover, its withdrawal is also very difficult, so it should be taken very cautiously. So there are the few barbiturates which are used nowadays and very rarely used. The one is the phenobarbital and the thiopental. Phenobarbital mainly used for the epilepsy, thiopental mainly used for the anesthesia. These two barbiturates are using nowadays. Moreover, these are also subsided by the benzodiazepine use nowadays. So there is no other barbiturate known which is used nowadays, and they are occasionally employed as the adjuvants in the psychomatic disorders. Dose, if you want to know, is 30 to 60 milligram orally, and TDS, OD to TDS, one time a day to three time a day, and in injection form it is 100 to 200 milligram IV intravenously, right? And the another is phenobarbital, and its dose is 200 milligram per ml injection. It is also given intravenously. So these are the doses I mentioned here, in case you are wondering about the doses. So this was the topic about the barbiturate. I hope you understand this video completely. In the next video I will discuss about the other depressants.